I'll talk about two, three use cases, and not as specific use cases, but classes of use cases, right? So there are, within AI, there are many levels of AI APIs also. So there are some very simple APIs like interpret an image,
right?
Or interpret a tweet, right? What is the sentiment of it? Or interpret a voice, right? A cough. Right. So for example, people are building cough-based COVID detection, right? Is it COVID or not, asthma or not, right? So how to interpret little things is one level of AI. This happens in our sensory system. Our nose interprets the smell. Our ear interprets the voice. Our eyes interpret the vision, right? So these are interpretation level AIs. This is what a lot of people think AI is, the interpretation layer. But that is just the outermost surface of how data comes in and gets interpreted and then goes in. What goes to the brain is where real intelligence happens. So interpretation is not the end of AI. It is the beginning. Once the data is converted into high risk, medium risk, low risk, right? Your CIBIL score. That is interpretation. That is not the end of it, right? Now, the next level complexity is, how do you put multiple such interpretations together to come up with the state of something? So for example, if I want to know the state of the health, the state of the market, the state of a customer in my business, whatever, I need multiple interpretations coming in to say this is the state of something, right? Like the state of a student in education, the state of a farm, the state of a whatever, right? So this state thinking is what is very important. How do you characterize the state of something? So that is the second layer. So I have interpreted everything. Now I have completed and come up with the state of everything. The next thing is, what action can I take here is the next thing. So that is my data science really starts from there and say, if you're in this state, do this. If you're in this state, do this. And we do this all the time. A doctor says, oh, you have this disease, so you are in this state, therefore you should do this.
Right.
So it's nothing weird about it. And then we look at the result and we say, did we fix the problem or not fix the problem? And again, go back and learn. So that is the loop. Now, in this whole thing, what makes an AI problem a complex problem? So my favorite problems are when the number of, so Ola was one of my favorite problems, right? Search was not a very hard problem, but Ola was a very hard problem. So, what makes that, I call it a complex system. A complex system modeling is a very difficult AI problem. Converting a tweet into a sentiment is a very simple AI problem. But modeling or optimizing a supply demand scenario in a two-sided complicated marketplace is a very complex model, right? Same thing in what we are doing in telecom now. We are trying to understand how to jointly optimize all the tilts of all the towers to give the best service to all the consumers. So again, it's a complex problem because it's a joint optimization of many, many things, right? Same thing if we are going to apply this in a refinery. Imagine it's a complex system. Crude comes in on one side, it goes through many, many plants, and then at the end, something comes out. How do you do end-to-end optimization, right? What crude to buy 6 months ago to what to sell 1 year later, and how to produce it in the optimal manner, right? So this, to me, is one kind of complex set of problems that I am now excited about. Interpretation problems are done. I'm not even going to look at them. I'm going to say, I don't need to know how to cut a vegetable. That is already done. Right. What I need to know is how to make a soup by mixing all this together in the right level and all that. And then how to make the whole entree, right? The whole meal. So solving complex problems like that is one area that excites me. The other area is, I think this new age AI has to evolve. The current AI is very brute force. It is not exactly the way humans learn to think about things, right? We don't learn to understand images by looking at millions and millions of labeled examples.
Right.
And then say, now I know what is a cat versus a dog. That is not how humans learn to see. So there is still something missing in the way we are practicing AI. And I'm trying to figure out what that is. What happens in early childhood to us, which makes it very easy for us to learn how to see or recognize objects with very few examples.
Right.
So something is happening there, which we are not able to figure out yet. So we are still struggling with that. So how do we build these natural intelligent system, not artificial intelligent systems, right? Is what my next struggle is, which is, how do we learn to speak and to hear ourselves simultaneously? Because you've seen that people who cannot speak well also cannot hear well, and vice versa. So this area of AI where creativity or generation of language and understanding of language, generation of speech and understanding of speech is a joint problem.
Right.
It's a joint problem. We have been solving only one-sided, right? Understand speech to text as a separate problem. Understand text to speech as a separate problem. But unless you combine what I call synthesis and analysis together, we will not be able to do anything. See, all intelligent systems must be able to do both things simultaneously. Like when I read and understand language, but if I cannot write a document myself, I have not really mastered language, right? I should be able to produce a document like I can read a document. So today, you know, for the last 20 years, Google has been able to understand a document to a different level of detail, keyword level, topic level, subtle levels, but it has not been able to generate the document. Now we are ready to generate documents. So you see, generation and creativity part of AI is so much happening later than the analysis part. So we have only solved half of AI. We have not solved the other half. So with the GANs and other things, now we are ready to solve the next half, which is how to create. And once we can understand and create simultaneously, that's where it will become automatic. And that is where the next generation AI is going to be, is the other problem that we are trying to figure out.
Okay.